In child custody cases, many things, as you can imagine, can't go wrong and will go wrong if you don't properly and carefully plan your case with us. So I look forward to working with you in your child custody case. Let me go over a few of the pitfalls I've seen other clients make and how to avoid them. First, make sure with any academic release form that's held at a principal's office that if you filled it out that you included the co-parent, the mother or father, on that form. Don't leave them off. It's very important. Also make sure their number and email are properly listed. If you leave them off or leave off their phone number, email, or improperly listed, it could be seen as intentional and could be seen as isolating that parent from the child and its relationship and the sharing of information, either academic or medical. Next, participate in activities. Make sure you're coordinating jointly with the other parent the activities of your children. Make sure you're openly and actively communicating their schedules and the games. Make sure you're attending them. And make sure you're an active participant in those, particularly under the scrutiny of a custody case. Third, consider earlier than you imagine or expect, typically, under the scrutiny of a custody case, to provide the itinerary, the travel schedule for summer and holidays well in advance. And make sure you're having that conversation by phone so that the tone is understood with the other parent, and then confirming it in writing. That's particularly important if you've gone over a summer schedule and where you plan to go, and then the week arrives that you want to take your child on vacation, and then they act like they never discussed it with you. So it's important to call and speak with them to the extent possible, and then confirm that in writing. And then finally, watch the grandparents. Many custody cases are stoked and the fire burns hot by the energy and the influence that the parents of a child's parents, in your case, have over them. So be careful of the grandparents. I recall helping a custody client recently, and the other parents, or the child's grandparents on the other side, wanted to see the child for a weekend. They lived out of town, and she was going to block them or stop them from seeing the child because, after all, it's not the father, so they don't have a right to see them. But I counseled her to allow the grandparents to see the child under a structured environment and with an understood itinerary, because it was so important to appear and to have good relations with the grandparents in your case, and their happiness and satisfaction might even allow the case to settle more easily and quicker. So watch the grandparents, treat them as well as you would treat the father and the mother in your case. Sometimes they're unbearable, sometimes they create more problems than it's worth. In those cases, document in writing the expectation. Maybe it's just going to be a few hours, maybe it's a single overnight with an itinerary understood. If that proves impossible because of other facts, we can talk about that. Each custody case is incredibly unique. The players and the facts around it are extremely unique. Each time I think I've seen it all, and then there's a different combination that presents itself, and that leads to different advice. So providing pitfall advice on custody cases can be difficult. We look forward to helping you and providing the unique strategy your case deserves.